Hello, my name is Andrea Grosso and today I will talk to you about the acoustic camera software. Transient noise is a noise that changes over time, like for example a startup of a machinery, a door slam or a run-up of an engine. To be able to map the sound in this condition is necessary to use a multiple probe solution and a multiple channel front-end. The alternative is to relate the measurement to some working condition of the machinery, but this requires additional reference channel and complex method for the calculation.
The Microflown Acoustic Camera is a direct method to measure the particle velocity in the near field. As the velocity is a vector, it is very well correlated with the surface vibration and it is not affected by background noise and reflections. For this reason, the camera can be also used in non-anechoic environment. Compared with acoustic holography and beamforming, the Microflown Acoustic Camera has different advantages. First, it is possible to create any kind of geometry and shapes of the array. It is important to follow with each probe the curved surfaces. The geometry and size of the array does not condition the frequency range of the acoustic camera, which is always 20-20 kHz. As the method is the direct method, the spatial resolution does not depend on the geometry of the array, but only on the spacing between the different probes. The dynamic range is over 40 dB, much higher as compared with acoustic holography or beamforming. As the method does not require complex calculation, can be also used by non-acoustic expert.
The software is divided into recorder and processing. First, all the data are stored in the hard drive, then it's possible to process all the time history and use an RPM reference sensor for order tracking. In the visualize tab, it's possible to show color maps of velocity, pressure and intensity in certain frequency band, spectrogram over time for each probe, octave and third octave. Also, it's possible to play back the audio of each probe and create video in AVI format. The acoustic camera has mainly field of application in automotive, aerospace, industrial machinery and consumer goods.
The option to deploy a scatter array make it possible to use the acoustic camera even in a very complex environment like a car interior. The panel noise contribution uses probes in triangular mounting, which decouple the probe from the surface. The panel noise contribution was performed with the windows method, using absorbing material to cover the surface inside the car. With this method was not possible to perform measurement under driving condition. With the acoustic camera, it's possible to perform the panel noise contribution in real driving condition.
Inside the car, high velocity at the surface does not necessarily mean a high pressure perceived to the driver's ear. This is because the pressure depends on the relative panel phase and the transfer path. The add-on for the acoustic camera called PNCIR, panel noise contribution analysis reference related, use the same hardware of the acoustic camera to perform airborne transfer path analysis. Combining together the measurement at the surface of the car interior and all the transfer function, it's possible to synthesize the pressure at the driver's ear position. The software can elaborate spectrograms and color maps to give an overview of the pressure coming from different panels area and achieve a source ranking which allow optimizing the trimmer panels in the car interior, with the minimum impact on cost for development.
The acoustic camera becomes, in this way, a tool for both sensors localization and airborne transfer path analysis. Depending on the requirements of the development stage of a product, it is possible to choose the most suitable method of analysis and maximize the advantages of the particle velocity sensor in the near field.
I hope you enjoyed the presentation. For further information, contact us at our phone or by email.